I have been using a lot of boring terms recently. So this video, you're going to be chill. And let's try to refreshing again what we know about classes. Another scenario, if you are joining some weird organization, yeah. So in order to become a registered member of the organizations, you need to deposit like 50 ringgit first. So now you need a constructor, right? It's because everyone is donating a different amount of money. So you need to verify that if that person is eligible to become the member of the organization. This time, you're going to put the money, the donation, as the user input. So the user will input how much money you actually donate. And inside here, you'll do the validation. If he donates less than 50 ringgit, he's not eligible to be the class member. So you need to throw him out of this organization. Else, if he or she is eligible, so you will put them as the member of the organization. The same thing as the use of constructor. So constructor, you can play like many different kind of game that you want to manage your codes. So try to be entertained, be motivated, when you're writing your codes. Play around with the constructor, yeah. Constructor is just something that you set the value to the attributes so that you can process it, like do anything you want with the codes. I always been mentioning about the keyword contract, and you also need to be remembering the keyword contract. Yeah, every items in the constructor you define is the contract to become the member of that class. You need to put, like for example, you give the space of 3 variables in the constructor. In order for another new instance coming out, you need to put in 3 variables as well with the exact same type and sequence. So this is the only gap between you and other class, or you and other things get that want to use you. Relax, chill. We're writing codes, writing codes is definitely very very fun game. So that's it for the chill session. We'll go into details of OOP later on. See ya.